What's up? I'm Height.
And I'm Cherie.
And this is Axiom Amnesia.
The thing that Bobby did that I felt was admirable was he wasn't just like, oh, well, Jimmy, you know, he'll show up, he'll turn up. He was always trying to be proactive. He's going to look for his son, because I guarantee if they had come to the door and Carol answered, Carol would have been like, he ain't here. And they'd have looked through and then she'd have shut that door and sat right on back down.
Yeah.
And that would have been it. So
what happens if he don't run off? Jimmy don't run off. Does the movie just end there?
You know? No, if he doesn't run off, then like when Jimmy's finished with his detention center time, then, you know, Bobby's waiting out front, sitting on the hood of the car, just like at the beginning of the movie when Bobby gets out of prison, his friends are there.
What's up, Deuce? Deuce!
Except this time, this is Dad, and then they play that, you know, optimistic music that they keep shoving in our faces every time Bobby does something good.
You gonna ride down on Willie Manchester?
Of course I am, but I need J-Rock.
He at Ray Ray's storehouse.
Bobby shows up over at Ray Ray's storehouse, a warehouse, whatever, and he's like, you see my boy?
I'm looking for my boy, Ray Ray. You seen him?
He never really confronted Ray Ray. He know all that Loco told him and what happened to his son. Because at first I was thinking, oh, they're greeting just a little. There's no excitement or nothing there, but it's no confrontation there either. He's just like, where my boy at?
So what I wonder is whether, you know, because he had the whole Ali effect on him, right? Where he's doing his conflict management. He's not going to confront because he's there for one goal, which is to get his son and him and his son get out of there, right? So he can't lose sight of that goal.
Yeah.
So he don't want to fight Ray Ray at this point. But if it was the old Bobby, I do think the old Bobby would have snapped off on him at this point.
But the new Bobby can butter him up. Oh, dang, Ray Ray, it's been forever. You know, of course, there's something I have changed. Mm. You know what I'm saying? Mm. You know?
And let us not forget, Ray Ray does say he heard some bad things.
You got out the joint, homeboy. Also heard a whole lot of other bad shit.
Which I'm assuming word got back out that, you know, Bobby had left the deuces alone.
I'm sure that got back. And then from Lil Jimmy, too.
As Ray Ray attempts to convince Bobby to come back to the life, he's telling him, you know, half this is yours.
Bruh.
And do you, you know, did we owe you and da 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 da.
Deuce is 50,000 strong all across L.A. now, Bobby. I owe you, man. Half this shit is yours.
He's like, we 50,000 strong. Where he get these numbers from? I want to know. Like, as you're looking at the FBI report.
Trump numbers.
But also... So we owe you half of this is out. So he's going to use that later, OG Bobby Johnson. I think it's too close to the moment that he's going to use this. Hey, earlier you said this. Mm-hmm. It should have been written in somewhere earlier in the film where it all comes to a head. And he's like, man, you said you owe in a letter way back.
Mm-hmm.
You wrote this, you know, that sort of a thing. But, you know, there's little things like that, but it's still... paid off, you know, to throw that line in there.
Bobby finds Jimmy there, and Jimmy has his bandana on in the same style that Bobby had his on when he took out Jeannie Lamb. And he's saying, hey, I'm not going back to the detention center. And, you know, Bobby continues to try to reason with him.
Jimmy.
I ain't going back there.
Listen, son, you're doing this wrong.
Bobby did. Push back against Ray Ray and told basically when he tries to interject himself into to the conversation between him and his son. And he's like, this is my son. You know, you get out of my business.
You don't want to go back there. That ain't no place for a deuce. This is not your business.
But let me just rewind. And they're talking about, you know, Bobby going back. I mean, they're talking about Jimmy going back to the detention center.
Yeah.
And my question is, well, if he was going to a detention center, then what could the mother have realistically done to keep him out of the detention center?
Yeah, when it's
there's something wrong with this plot here. Because if it was just a group home, that's a
yeah, but it's like he had this whole production with this letter of they took Jimmy, right?
Yeah. There, from the point that he got caught up in what he got caught up in, there would have been nothing that the mother could have done to get him.
Yeah.
So then why this whole thing?
Major hole.
You know, yeah. So That epiphany just occurred.
I'm going to just act like they didn't say detention center, and I'm going to look at it as a group home.
Well, that's why I always looked at it as a group home, because I felt that the context clues were like, oh, this is a group home. It's set up like a group home. It doesn't really appear to be any locks, you know, and stuff like that. You know, not quite exactly the boot camp type of thing. Oliver Stone.
Oliver Stone, I know you read and watched this, bro.
I got questions, Oliver Stone. Please explain.
The thing
it.
Is, Oliver Stone is a huge name. His name is on this thing.
Yes.
You got to answer. You got to come back after 30 years and answer some questions.
Yes. Then we see Ray Ray say, you know, basically the county is his mama and Deuce is his daddy and I am Deuce.
Now the county's his mama now and Deuce is his daddy and I am Deuce.
Okay, so what Ray Ray is also doing, you know, Ray Ray had invested a lot, right, in Jimmy. Ray Ray was making, you know, he invested, he basically took him under his wing. He was his mentor, and he is not going to just let him go, right? Mm. This is the next generation that he'll have control over, and he is not going to just let him go to his daddy. He's like,
but
look.
But dang, one little dude out of your 50,000,
well,
bro.
Listen, he was stealing plenty of those, he was stealing a lot of those radios. Yeah,
he was bringing them $400 at a time.
Well, not only that, bringing the friends, right? Because he was kind of a little leader amongst his friends.
Yeah, I guess,
you know, you got to look at the pyramid of it all.
Yeah, but I think it's a little heavy-handed for this.
Probably
for just happens to be his son.
Yeah,
and that just advances the story, but in the grand scheme of in the head of Deuce, and I care about what happens to this one little kid going down to kitty jail. Like,
We did do a poll on this, and the vast majority, probably like close to 90%, 85% of the people said that they felt that Ray Ray was just using Jimmy. And because the question was, did Ray Ray love Jimmy or was he just using him? And most people felt that he was just using him. I agree, he was just using him. I don't think he loved him. He was a means to an end.
I think he did, possibly. Not like love him, but he had some attachment to him because of Bobby.
Yeah. Now,
you know, and maybe he thought he was doing something for him by allowing him to run with Deuce, basically.
Well, see, I do think that Ray Ray loved Bobby, you know, the way you would love a brother. I think he did. And I think Ray Ray thought his lifestyle was right. And I also think that Ray Ray was willing to share the spoils with Bobby, right? Because he
just
did.
No one else.
Just nobody else, right? But Ray Ray was also short-sighted in that you didn't do the right thing for Bobby's son, which would have been the best way to honor Bobby, right? But you didn't do him right. But maybe he just ain't know how to do right either.
So if you look at the circumstances, what do you do? I guess he's trying to, in whatever way he has, right, as a father figure, train Jimmy in a way in which
give
he should
money
go.
Give him money and tell him to stay off the streets.
Well, that's not enough. If you don't know anything else, but this is how you survive because you don't have a mother, basically. You don't have a father because he's in prison. So here's some money. You could steal radios and spread this amongst your friend so that you can grow into whatever his ideal of a man is. It's wrong, right? He's wrong, but I think that's part of it. But for the sake of it helps him out, but I can use you too now. So I'm just going to build you up so that you in the future, you'll be one of my customers because he's still probably like, just buy from me. Okay. So Ray Ray is like, let Jimmy decide.
Let him decide for himself. You want to stay with us or you want to go back to kitty jail?
I ain't going back there.
But why Ray Ray gets to decide the rules here?
Well, and furthermore, why would anybody suggest that the 10-year-old knows what's best for his life at this point?
Well, because he knows what the answer is going to be, right?
Yeah. I mean, like, that's insane, you know, but it reminds me of just this notion that, you know, little kids.
Democracy.
Yeah. Yeah. Whatever you want to do. Nah, you 10 years old. This is why you're issued parents. And your parents will decide until you become of age enough to make the decision for yourself. And certainly this cat over here doesn't get to say,
random
let him
cat.
Decide for his
nah. I know. And then Bobby starts to plead. All right, now I'm going to convince him. When Ray Ray set up the rules of this game, he rigged it from the beginning.
He sure did.
Ray Ray come and pull old man Willie Manchester out of a closet or somewhere. And I'm like, man, this boy, we need to be, you know what I'm saying. All right. They found Willie Manchester, who had gunned down a 10-year-old black boy. That's all I'm saying.
Now we are full circle, almost just like when Jeannie Lamp got, right? You know, we're standing here and it is Jimmy's potential initiation. He is being challenged by Ray Ray to go ahead and take out the dude who shot him in his back. And when confronted, when he realizes who Jimmy is, you know, because Jimmy got to be like, oh, okay, let me lift up my shirt and show you this, my back being jacked up.
That was an accident. I was protecting my family.
Stop bitching.
And that's when he's like, oh, that was an accident. And then he says, well, I was protecting my family. Huh. And so yeah, it's an accident now. Because it wasn't an accident the night it happened.
I wonder if Willie Manchester could have been written as white or been white.
That might have been too much.
Yeah, that's what I'm thinking.
That would have derailed the thing. But then I also think that we have to address the Willie Manchesters amongst us, right? Because we do have people who feel justified in acting on behalf of white supremacy.
Yeah, but just the idea that it's my goods, and they mentioned the actual word goods was very weird
so many times
in the movie, that it has this connotation, right? And I guess for me, being someone who reads up on capitalism all the time, is I just instantly go to economy, economics, capitalism when somebody started talking about goods and what comes along with that.
We have Jimmy now having, you know, the angel on one shoulder and the devil on the other. His father trying to say, don't do this man in. And then, of course, Ray Ray, like, you got, you know, go on and get him and, yeah, you know, do everything. And it's really in this moment, yeah, kind of up to Jimmy.
Yeah, but this guy pleading to me is very ironic. That you're pleading for your life. No, don't do this.
Mm-hmm.
Right? And then you get the speech from OG Bobby Johnson about, if you steal from a man,
mm-hmm,
you could. All Jimmy was doing was stealing, and this dude basically tried to off him.
Yeah.
And now he's in a position where he's like, no, don't do this. Be a good person. You basically, like, you don't need to do this. But that's exactly what this dude decided to do. So it's, if it wasn't for OG Bobby Johnson being there and saying that this is about my kid's future, then I'd just be like, man, just go ahead and take that boy out, man.
Like, well, they needed to have it like that. This is the dilemma, because, you know, the Willie Manchesters of our community are actually a cancer in those communities.
Yeah,
they are like, not, they are an ill of the community.
And it's like, for our future, we must have Willie Manchester survive.
You know, it's a tough one. But like, I would say at a minimum, you know, people who are destructive to the community have to be ejected.
Mm.
Like, and a child who, you know, doesn't know any better is one thing. But an adult grown man,
yeah,
who just is like, I'm protecting my family, knowing you weren't, and who would put goods over the life of an individual, I don't care how lowly you think they are. But see, the fact that he referred to him as a bastard,
yeah,
lets you know the judgment that comes along with things, right? Because again, he's calling, yeah, him essentially a fatherless child,
right?
Which is what this whole movie is trying to highlight,
right? And then, you know, they mentioned you know, basically going to fight for his country and stuff. That's why I think, like, it's supposed to be a white guy. Because I guess they use these same tropes and apply it to black guys. So like, if you're going to get black men who were in the military to be on a jury, you know, the stereotype is that, hey, you probably want somebody in the military because they're going to side a certain way, possibly for law enforcement or authority, right?
Mm-hmm.
But if you throw a black one into the mix, you make those same assumptions, you might end up being wrong. Which is why when they throw that on this character, it really depends on the intentions of the writers, why they would have him be someone who's a veteran.
Hmm. So much to unpack with this, really.
Yeah.
And a lot of different ways to look at it. But, you know, it's a tough one. It's a tough one.
Jimmy, don't do it.
Just steady, aim, and pull on up.
No!
Okay, it's always in movies that just make me laugh is when they become martial art experts.
Yeah.
It's kind of like Nino Brown did in New Jack City. At the end of the movie, he's like a ninja.
Yes.
Like, what in the world is going on? And here, you got OG Bobby Johnson. He hits him in the neck, which was really funny. He comes with a knee and a chop. And, well, come on now. Bruh.
Glenn was probably like, I want to do my own stunts.
And that symbolism of OG Bobby Johnson standing in front of Willie Manchester, in essence, protecting Willie Manchester.
Mm-hmm.
And that could be an intention by someone. I don't know.
I think it's definitely an intention.
Prisoner sure made him stupid.
Let us talk about this. You just said prison sure has made him
stupid. That's what Ray Ray
said. He is. But he also is about to put the gun down.
That's what made him stupid.
He's about to put the gun down in a situation where two other people in the room are armed and pointing guns at him.
Yeah.
You know, again, this is just what you... They were too dedicated to trying to...
To be nonviolent,
And have this message. It could have been that he says, listen, you know, he could have took out Ray Ray. And if he was lucky enough, be able to take out Bear too. Or maybe Bear would stand down. And then he just walks off and been like, look, I had to do that. But let me teach you right from now on. And then the sun could go down.
Before we get to the ending, I would say I have an alternate ending. What if Bobby popped Ray Ray and then Ray Ray makes a mistake because he got popped. He popped Willie Manchester and they both go down and they dead. But Bobby, OG Bobby Johnson gets off because this is self-defense and he was just here trying to get his kid. Bam, we took out Willie Manchester. Bam, we took out Ray Ray. Happy ending. They go off into the sunset. He raises his kid the way he should be raised. And then Bear has a new lease on life or whatever. I don't care what happened.
And then
to
at the end, you see Carol coming out of the rehab center and they're both waiting for her and then they're a family and it's just happily ever
after. Yeah, but he put the gun down. I know Willie Manchester is like, this dude is stupid.
Prison sure has made you stupid.
OG Bobby Johnson told Ray Ray that he told a man in prison, Ali, that he was willing, he's going to save his son's life even if it took his own life. And then he says, I'm willing to die here today.
After he lays the gun down.
Yeah. And if they pop you, that's not going to save your son's life.
Because he's just going to still be with Deuce and have whatever ending that is, in jail or dead.
Yeah, you need to say this with the piece held up. I'm just saying. I'm willing to go back to prison to meet Ali and do the same thing he done.
I'm going to have to just be on Ali's, you know. I'm going to be helping other people try to save.
Yeah, to save my son.
Come back in and be like, Ali, I saved my son. But I wound up back over here.
Dang.
So in this scene, you know, we see Bobby trying to convince him. And he's like, you owe me. We didn't have a father. I'm just trying to give him what we didn't have. And
all I want is to give him something that you or I never had.
He's doing all of this, you know, emotional appeal to Ray Ray. And toward the end of that, you see Ray Ray with the gun on one side and the hand on the other. And I know that was just supposed to be so symbolic, but some of it is the stupidity of how this was put together that leads to this moment takes away from what could have been a lot more symbolism in terms of the gun versus the hand. He's the hand reaching out to help, right? He's reaching out his hand to get his son, and the gun, you know, being the opposite of that.
Yeah, and then is that a compelling argument? Because it makes it seem as though someone in Ray Ray's position, that he is just so, I guess kind of what Ali said, he is angry because he doesn't have a father. So now he is so overwhelmingly compelled by this speech about not having a father. He's like, yeah, J-Rock should have a father.
Well, and then go back to the question, do you love him, right? This was the same question that we asked the viewers and the same questions that the viewers should be asking themselves. And the answer is that, well, my answer is that he didn't love him.
Well,
but then the answer of what's being shown here is that he did love him because he loved him enough to let him go back
to his father. I don't think so.
You know, but like it's mixed messaging.
Because the question is in that if I love him, you don't. So send him to me, to someone who loves him.
But then why do you let him go? if you don't really care and he's for your use.
It's not a good use of the question in the moment.
It's just, it's bad. And it's a bad question.
So then what we do see, he makes this whole compelling speech and everything. And then J-Rock looks up at Ray Ray like, I want to go with my daddy.
Okay, so in the end, he gets his son back and everything. They're about to leave, and then they're wondering, what are they going to do with old boy? And it don't take old boy no chance to get out of there. He's running. He's getting out. He is doing what your sensibilities would tell you to do in a situation with these crazy fools. But, you know, Bobby is moving slow, and he's got his son, and he's like, we're going to start all over, and it's going to be all good.
Bobby trusts him, I guess. But the way that Jimmy looked up at Ray Ray and then he just went and embraced his daddy and stuff. After all that we've seen here in this, the ending, I don't think that's possible without Nurse Shelley's compassion. Without him going to the hospital and getting mixed up with Nurse Shelley and may having him open up and have some sort of compassion and care about stuff other than, I just guess, basic survival, that he was allowed to see his father's compassion and actual love for him, that he would be like, okay, this is a person is kind of like a Nurse Shelley, so I want to go with him and give that a chance.
I don't know how much contact that Ray Ray had with him throughout the years, but certainly he was closer to Ray Ray than he was his father, because he had no relationship with his father while he was in prison. So you're choosing somebody you essentially don't know over somebody you do know that you thought cared about you, right? Because that's why he would run to Ray Ray. That's why he worked for Ray Ray, you know, because he thought he was caring about, you know, he was the father figure that he had.
Yeah, but Nurse Shelley showed him something different. And I think that's that would make her a very pivotal character in this movie.
Probably the most important.
And I wonder what a lot of other people think.
More important than his father.
Yes. More important. But I don't know, because it would take his father, right, to come get him out of this situation. But does he run away if OG Bobby Johnson don't go visit him? Right?
Yes, he runs away because he doesn't want to be in that situation.
On that day, because it was kind of like when his daddy showed up, he was like, we can do it tonight. And then it ends up being basically the next day or the same day that he runs away.
I think he wanted to leave and he thought his father was going to help him, you know, get out of there. And then his father wasn't on board. So he was like, I guess I got to go, you know, run and go on to Ray Ray, and then Ray Ray going to help me.
It seemed like he was just there until it's a grand coincidence for me that when his daddy show up, then he leave.
I don't know. Take it to the comments. What do you guys think? Do you think that if his father hadn't shown up, that he would run, that he would have run away from the detention center? Right. The detention center / group home / we don't want to really know what it is.
If he runs away, and if it doesn't matter if his daddy's not there, then they still ride down on old man Willie Manchester and he ain't there no more. So you still need OG Bobby Johnson and Nurse Shelley for him to see the love from Nurse Shelley and to see that in OG Bobby Johnson.
Right.
And you need Ali to basically have him have this attitude change per se. Just so the way Ali showed OG Bobby Johnson is how Nurse Shelley showed Jimmy. You know, so one from a man and one from a woman.
And it was nurturing. Even Ali was nurturing.
Yeah.
Let us not get that confused.
He's basically like, you my son now.
Yeah, yeah.
And Bear is still on the ground, and they always do that in movies. You're going to be knocked out for 10, 20, 30 minutes. Do they have a quote at the end of this movie?
No. So the movie ends where, you know, Bobby and his son walk off into the sunset. And you asked if there was a quote at the end of this movie. There isn't. And I guess it would have been apropos had they just placed some quote, you know, fathers matter, whatever the message that they were.
25% of blah.
Yeah.
Blah. One out of. If you made it this far, then type for Ray Ray in the comments so we'll know you're one of the real ones who stuck around to the end of this.
Thank you so much. Please remember to subscribe and hit the bell so you know the next time we drop one of these bangers.